DHTs are distributed hash tables. So a hash table is actually a data structure where you can store entries connected to a key. So you can look up an entry for a key. So similarly to a phone book where you look up a telephone number by a name. So, and the distributed is now important. So it's a distributed data structure where in a distributed peer-to-peer network, the different nodes store different parts of this hash table. So imagine you want to store a phone book, or you want to build this application with your friends. You take a phone book and you separate it out into smaller pieces, and each of your, say, 10 friends holds 1/10 of this phone book. And you also have a mapping of who holds which piece. So if you now need to look up a name or a if you now need to look up a telephone number, what you actually do is you find out who is holding that piece of the phone book, and you ask this person. And so you're able to retrieve your data that you need without needing to store everything on, well, in your phone book, on your copy. So, and this is what leverages the main difference to blockchain, where everybody actually stores the complete phone book, which is overloading the network. And so if anybody somewhere else on this world gets a new telephone, everybody needs to update that. And with DHTs, we don't need everybody to update that, but only those who are storing this portion of the phone book.